So in the last class we were discussing about the derivation of uniform flow formulae such as Manning's formula and Chase's formula. If you recall, we derived Manning's formula from Chase's formula. Then we solved a couple of simple problems based on Chase's formula and Manning's formula. We'll move further. In this class, we are going to discuss about most economical section of a channel. First, we'll define what is this most economical section. Then we'll derive equations for different types of sections such as rectangular section, trapezoidal section, circular section. So first we'll define what is most economical section. Most economical section is called the best hydraulic section or most efficient section, as the discharge passing through a given cross-sectional area, bed slope and a frictional coefficient is maximum. In other words, for a given cross-sectional area, bed slope and frictional resistance, the discharge is maximum for a given section, then that section we call it as most economical section. Now, when do we say that the section is most economical? For that, let us consider this equation Q is equal to A into V. Now, what I am going to do is, in place of V, I am going to substitute this C into root of RS. What is this C into root of RS? That is Chase's formula. In the last class, we derived two formulae for uniform flow. One is Chase's formula, V is equal to C into root of RS, and Manning's formula, V is equal to 1 over n, s to the power of half, r to the power of 2/3. Now in this case, in place of V, I am going to substitute this C into root of RS. Therefore, you are going to get this Q is equal to AC into root of RS. Now what is R? R is hydraulic mean radius, that is given by the ratio of wetted area to the wetted perimeter, that is given by A divided by P. In other words, so this equation becomes Q is equal to AC into root of A divided by P into S naught. So if you further simplify this, you are going to get this Q is proportional to 1 over root P. Okay, so why it is 1 over root P? Because the definition of most economical section says that the discharge is maximum for a given cross-sectional area, bed slope and the frictional resistance. Therefore, Q is proportional to 1 over root P. So what is the conclusion we are going to draw from this? The conclusion we are going to draw from this is discharge Q will be maximum when the perimeter is minimum. So we are going to make use of this condition while deriving the equations for this most economical section for different cross sections. Let us start with the first cross section, that is rectangular section, most economical rectangular section. So consider a rectangular section having a base width B. Let the depth of flow in the channel is given by small y. Then the wetted area is given by B into y, that is capital A wetted area is equal to B into y. So call this as equation number 1. Then find the wetted perimeter. Wetted perimeter P is equal to B plus 2 times the depth of flow. So call this as equation number 2. Now consider equation 1. From equation 1, I want the value of B. So B is equal to A divided by Y. Now substitute this value of B in equation 2. We are going to get, so P is equal to A by Y plus 2Y. Call this equation as 3. Now write the condition for most economical section. For most economical section, P should be minimum for a given area. That is, differentiate equation 3 with respect to y and equate the same to 0. That is, dp by dy is equal to 0. So in the next step, what I am going to do is, I am going to differentiate equation 3 with respect to y and equate the same to 0. Let us do that. Differentiate equation 3 with respect to y and equate the same to 0, we have dp by dy is equal to 0. Therefore, dp by dy is equal to d by dy of, so what is the value of p? So p is given by a divided by y plus 2y, this is equal to 0. So if you differentiate this, you are going to get minus a by y square plus 2 is equal to 0. So push this negative term to the other side, you are going to get a by y square is equal to 2. So at this stage, I am going to substitute the value of a. It is a rectangular section. The wetted area is given by b into y. So in place of a, if I substitute this by, so by divided by y square is equal to 2, or on simplification, you are going to get this b is equal to 2 times y. This is first condition. Now, consider the hydraulic mean radius, r. So as I mentioned earlier, r is the ratio of wetted area to the wetted perimeter. R is equal to a divided by p. Now, in this case, a is by and perimeter p is equal to b plus 2y. But just now we showed a relation between b and y, that is b is equal to 2y. Now in place of b, I am going to substitute the value of 2y. So if you substitute this value of 2y in place of b, okay, so you are going to get this r is equal to 2y square divided by 2y plus 2y. So if you simplify this, you are going to get this r, hydraulic mean radius, works out to be y divided by 2. So we have two conditions. One is the base width is equal to 2 times the depth of flow for a most economical section, and the other condition is the hydraulic mean radius for the most economical rectangular section is of the depth of flow. So this is how you are going to derive equation for most economical section, rectangular section. Then we move on to the next one and the important one, trapezoidal section, most economical trapezoidal section. So in order to derive an equation for this most economical trapezoidal section, consider a trapezoidal section having a base width b. Let y represents the depth of flow in the channel. The side slope is given by, for every one vertical there is n horizontal. Top width of the channel is given by capital T. Okay, so with this, let us derive an equation for this most economical section. So first, find the wetted area. Wetted area A is equal to B plus NY into Y. Call this as equation number one. Then wetted perimeter P is equal to B plus 2Y into root of n square plus 1. Call this as equation number 2. Now from equation 1, find the value of b. So b is equal to a divided by y minus ny. Now substitute the value of b in equation 2, we are going to get the value of p is equal to a divided by y minus ny plus 2y into root of n square plus 1. Call this as equation number 3. Now, write the condition for most economical section. For most economical section, P should be minimum for a given area. that is dp by dy is equal to 0. In the next step, I am going to differentiate equation 3 with respect to y and equate it to 0. Okay, let us do it. Differentiate equation 3 with respect to y and equate the same to 0, we have dp by dy is equal to 0. Dp by dy is equal to d by dy of a by y minus ny plus 2y into root of n square plus 1 is equal to 0. So if you differentiate this equation, you are going to get minus a by y square minus n plus 2 into root of n square plus 1. This is equal to 0. Now at this stage, what I am going to do is, in place of a, I am going to substitute the equation for this weighted area, that is a is equal to b plus ny into y. So if you substitute this b plus ny into y in place of a, you are going to get minus b plus ny into y divided by y square minus n plus 2 into root of n square plus 1, that is equal to 0. So if you simplify this equation, you are going to get minus b plus ny divided by y minus n plus 2 into root of n square plus 1 is equal to 0. If you further simplify this equation, you are going to get the condition for most economical trivial section. The condition is b plus 2ny is equal to 2y into root of n square plus 1. Call this as equation number 4. Then consider this hydraulic mean radius. Hydraulic mean radius is equal to a divided by p. Therefore, r is equal to, in place of a, I am going to write this b plus ny into y, and in place of p, I am going to write this b plus 2y into root of n square plus 1. Now, consider equation 4. If you observe equation number 4, so it says that b plus 2ny is equal to 2y into root of n square plus 1. So what I am going to do is, in the denominator, I am going to replace this 2y into root of n square plus 1 by b plus 2ny. If you do that, you are going to get this r is equal to b plus ny into y divided by b plus 2ny. Or if you simplify this, you are going to get b plus ny into y divided by 2 into b plus ny. b plus ny gets cancelled. You are going to get so y divided by 2. So this is the condition for the most economical trivial section. What is the condition? The hydraulic mean radius is of the depth of flow. So there are two conditions again for a trivial section to be most economical. One is b plus 2ny is equal to 2y into root of n square plus 1. The other one is hydraulic mean radius is equal to y divided by 2. Okay? Then there are other criteria for most economical trivial section. There are two cases. First, let us start with the first case. So what is the first case? When a semicircle is drawn with the trapezoidal center O, please refer to the figure, on the water surface and the radius equal to the depth of flow Y, the three sides of the channel are tangential to the semicircle. I repeat once again, when a semicircle is drawn with the trapezoidal center O on the water surface and the radius equal to the depth of flow Y, the three sides of the channel are tangential to the semicircle. So So what I mean to say is, now we need to prove that this OF is equal to OB is equal to O, you call that the other side by some name, maybe G, OG. OF is equal to OB is equal to OG. Now how to do that? For that, to prove this condition, using the figure shown, we have, please refer to the figure, consider the triangle OMF. Consider the triangle OMF. Now from this triangle OMF, OF is perpendicular to the side, therefore OF is equal to OM sine alpha. What is this alpha? Alpha is the angle made by the side of the trapezoid section with the horizontal. Therefore, OF is equal to OM sine alpha. Now, what is OM? So, if you call the top width as T, OM is T divided by 2. So, what is the top width for a trapezoid section? The top width T is given by B plus 2NY. Therefore, OM is equal to B plus 2NY divided by 2. Therefore, OF is equal to, in place of OM, I am going to write this B by 2 plus NY into sine alpha. Then, I want the value of sine alpha. Therefore, sine alpha is equal to OF divided by B by 2 plus NY. Now, consider the triangle KMN. KMN, N is missing in the figure. Kindly put this N. Okay. So, to the left of this B or the left side of this inclined side, that is B. That is MN is the inclined side. That N is missing, I am sorry. So, using the triangle KMN, we have sine alpha is equal to MK divided by MN. What is MK? MK is the depth of flow that is given by Y. Therefore, in place of MK, you write this Y. What is MN? MN is the diagonal for this triangle KMN. And this diagonal having a depth equal to Y, which is nothing but MK, MN works out to be, so Y into root of N square plus 1. So from triangle KMN, sine alpha is equal to Y divided by Y plus root of N square plus 1. But we showed that the sine alpha is equal to OF divided by B by 2 plus 1 NY. Call that equation as 1 and this as 2. Therefore, equate these two. Sine alpha is equal to OF divided by B by 2 plus NY. That is equal to Y divided by Y into root of N square plus 1. So, if you simplify this, the OF works out to be B divided by 2 plus NY divided by root of N square plus 1. Okay. Now, at this stage, I make use of the relation which I derived earlier for this most economical trapezoidal section, that is B plus 2NY is equal to 2y into root of n square plus 1. Therefore, this OF is equal to 2y. So, what I am right now doing, I am going to replace this b plus 2ny by 2y into root of n square plus 1 divided by 2 into root of n square plus 1. So, 2 gets cancelled. root of n squared plus 1, root of n squared plus 1 gets cancelled. So you are going to get OF is equal to y. Now we showed that OB is equal to OF. Similarly, if you consider the same triangle the other side, and if you prove it, you are going to show that this OF is equal to OB is equal to OG. So what is the conclusion you are going to draw? If a semicircle is drawn with O as center and the radius equal to the depth of flow y, the three sides of the most economical section will be tangential to the semicircle. That is the first case. We'll come to the second case, the best side slope for a trapezoidal section. Again, consider the trapezoidal section having a base width b, the depth of flow is equal to y, and the side slopes for every one vertical, n horizontal, and the top width is given by capital T, that is equal to b plus 2ny. Again, we will write the conditions or equation for wetted area and wetted perimeter. Wetted area, A is equal to b plus ny into y. So call this as equation number 1. Write the equation for wetted perimeter. So P is equal to b plus 2y into root of n squared plus 1. So call this as equation number 2. Again, from equation 1, find the value of b. So b is equal to a divided by y minus ny. Again, substitute this value of b in equation 2. So equation 2 simplifies to, so b is equal to a divided by y minus ny plus 2y into root of n square plus 1. So call this as equation as 3. Now, for most economical section, depth of flow y and area A are constant, and the side slope n is a variable. So if you recall, for a most economical section, P should be minimum for a given cross-sectional area, bed slope, and the frictional resistance. Therefore, we are going to get, or we are going to differentiate equation 3 with respect to n and equate it to 0 to get the best side slope for the trapezoidal section. Let us do that. So in the next step, what I'm going to do is I'm going to differentiate equation 3 with respect to n and equate the same to 0 and simplify it. Differentiate equation 3 with respect to here there is a typo, I'm going to change it afterwards, please put it as n, and equate the same to 0. We have, so dp by dn is equal to 0. Now dp d by dn, okay, d by dn of a divided by y minus ny plus 2y into root of n square plus 1, that is equal to 0. Now if you differentiate this equation with respect to n, you are going to get, so you are differentiating the equation with respect to n, in the first term there is no n term, therefore you are going to get 0. So differentiation of minus ny is minus n plus, so differentiation of 2y into root of n square plus 1 with respect to dn becomes 2y into root of n square plus 1 raised to half minus 1 into half, that is equal to 0. So if you simplify this, you are going to get 2ny is equal to y into root of n square plus 1. So yy gets cancelled on both sides, you are going to get 2n is equal to root of n square plus 1. Now square on both sides. So if you square on both sides, you're going to get 4n square is equal to n square plus 1, or 3n square is equal to 1. Find the value of n. So n is equal to 1 over root 3. That is, for most economical section, trapezoidal section I am talking about, the horizontal side for every one vertical, so my h is equal to 1 over root 3. Now corresponding to this value of n, theta works out to be 60 degrees. So the conclusion I am going to draw is the best side slope is at 60 degree to the horizontal. That is, of all trapezoidal sections, a off hexagon is most economical. Again, I repeat, of all trapezoidal sections, a off hexagon is most economical. But most of the time, constructing this off hexagon is very, very difficult. So sometimes we may not be in a position to construct this most economical trapezoidal section. That's about trapezoidal section. Then we'll move on to the next case, that is circular section. Now, if you recall, in the earlier two cases, so we found the most economical section. So keeping the wetted perimeter minimum. So if you talk about a rectangular section, so base width is fixed. The only variable is the depth of flow, whether it is a rectangular section, whether it is a trapezoidal section. And in both the cases, whether my depth of flow is half meter or 1 meter or 1.5 meter or 2 meter, the shape of the flow section will not change, whether it is a triangular trapezoidal section or a rectangular section. But in case of a circular section, the shape of the flow section changes from depth to depth. For example, please refer to the figure what I am presenting here. In this case, I am showing the depth of flow above the midpoint of the circular section. So in this case, the shape of the wetted area is different. Of course, P varies with the depth. Now if you consider another depth which is below the midpoint of the circular section, then the shape of that flow section is totally different. So that concept we are going to make use in order to derive this equation for the most economical circular section. So that is what I mentioned in the first paragraph. In case of the circular channels, the area of flow cannot be maintained constant. Indeed, the cross-sectional area A and the wetted perimeter both do not depend on D, the depth of flow, but they depend on the intended angle, that is theta. Whatever I am talking right now, that is with reference to the figure what I am presenting here. Now, referring to the figure, we can determine the wetted perimeter and the wetted area of flow as follows. Kindly refer to the ready table which I gave in the first class. Now for a circular section, the wetted area is given by A is equal to R square by 2 into theta minus sine theta. Call this as equation number 1. And wetted perimeter P is equal to R theta. Call this as equation number 2. Thus, in case of circular channels, For most economical section, two separate conditions are obtained. One is condition for maximum discharge. The second one is condition for maximum velocity. Let us consider the first condition, condition for maximum discharge. Now consider this discharge equation, Q is equal to A into V. Consider Chase's formula, V is equal to C into root of RS. In place of V, substitute this C into root of RS, you are going to get this Q is equal to AC into root of RS. We know that this R is equal to A divided by P. Therefore, if you introduce this A by P in place of R, and on simplification, you are going to get this Q is equal to Chase's constant C into root of A cube divided by P into S. Square on both sides, you are going to get Q square is equal to C square into A cube by P into S. Now, C is Chase's constant. Kindly recall, for the most economical section, the bed slope is constant. That is what I mentioned in the next sentence. Assuming Chase's constant C and S, the bed slope, to be constant, the discharge is maximum when A cube by P is maximum. I repeat, assuming Chase's constant C and the bed slope S to be constant, the discharge is maximum when A cube by P is maximum. Thus, differentiating A cube by P with respect to theta, we get Y theta. At the beginning, I said the shape of the flow section depends on the value of theta. Therefore, you are going to get d by d theta of A cube by P. So if you differentiate this equation with respect to theta, you are going to get P into 3a square into dA by d theta minus A cube into dP by d theta whole thing divided by P square, and that is equal to 0. So since on the right hand side you have 0, on simplification you are going to get 3P into dA by d theta minus A into dP by d theta is equal to 0. Call this as equation number 3. Now, weighted area is given by R square by 2 into theta minus sin theta, and P is equal to R theta. Now if you consider equation number 3, if you want to simplify this equation number 3, you want the value of dA by d theta and dP by d theta. That is the reason I consider this weighted area equation and weighted perimeter equation. Now find the value of dA by d theta. If you differentiate this weighted area with respect to theta, you are going to get dA by d theta is equal to R square by 2 into 1 minus cos theta. Similarly, if you do the same procedure for perimeter, you are going to get dP by d theta is equal to R. Look at equation number 3. You know the value of P, that is R theta. You know the value of A, that is R square by 2 into theta minus sin theta. dA by d theta is R square by 2 into 1 minus cos theta. And dP by d theta is equal to R. Substitute all these values. So what is the unknown? The unknown is the value of theta. Substituting the value of A, P, dA by d theta and dP by d theta in equation 3 and solving for theta, so theta works out to be approximately equal to 257.5 degree. Now Corresponding to this, theta is equal to 257.5 degree, the depth of flow is equal to 0.81 times the diameter of the circular section. I repeat, corresponding to this value of theta equal to 257.5 degree, the depth of flow is equal to 0.81 times the dia of the circular section. So this is the condition for maximum discharge. The condition for maximum discharge in case of the most economical circular section is given by theta is equal to 257.5 degree and the depth of flow is equal to 0.81 times the dia of the circular section. So in a similar fashion, we'll derive an equation for this condition for maximum velocity. Condition for maximum velocity for circular section. Now, Q is equal to A into V. Of course, since I am talking about velocity, I don't need that equation. Let us straight away consider the Chase's equation. So V is equal to C into root of RS. Again, in place of R, substitute this value of A divided by P. If you do that, you are going to get V is equal to C into root of A divided by P into S. Square on both sides, you are going to get V square is equal to C square into A divided by P into S. Again, assuming the Chase's constant C and the bed slope S are constant, velocity is maximum when A divided by P is maximum. Therefore, differentiate this A divided by P with respect to theta and equate it to 0, we get d of d theta into A by P. Therefore, that is equal to P into dA by d theta minus A into dP by d theta whole thing divided by P square. That is equal to 0. So again, since on the right hand side I have 0, so on simplification I am going to get this P into dA by d theta minus A into so dP by d theta, that is equal to 0. Again, if you want to simplify this equation, call this equation as 3. You want the value of A, you want the value of P, you want the value of dA by d theta and dP by d theta. So write the equation for this wetted area and wetted perimeter. So wetted area is given by R square by 2 into theta minus sine theta, and wetted perimeter P is equal to R theta. Therefore, dA by d theta is equal to R square by 2 into 1 minus cos theta, and dP by d theta is equal to R. Now, substitute the value of A, P, dA by d theta and dP by d theta in equation number 3 and solve for the value of theta. So if you simplify that, you are going to get the value of theta is approximately equal to, I think there is something wrong, it's 285, there is typo here, it is 285, and the value of d, that I'll give it in the next class.